All right. So let's move on to something else. Let's move on to Star Wars Squadrons, a game that I am following, and I'm quite excited about this game as well. And there's been a lot of footage, gameplay footage, regarding Star Wars Squadrons. This is footage that was taken by X2. I'll be putting the link to his two channel, Ekka's Ladder, which is one of my favorite Star Wars channels, and X2, which is his gaming channel, in the comment section down below. I'm not going to pause his video, by the way, unless I have his authorization. So I'm gonna have to contact him. But we'll do the live stream anyway, and we'll comment what we are seeing here in this footage. There's no comment. It's just pure footage, and I absolutely love what I'm seeing here, guys. So we're gonna have a look at this, and I want you guys to tell me what you guys think about this. So here we go. So what we are looking at now is footage from the fleet battle. So they're basically gonna have two multiplayer modes. There's gonna be the regular dogfighting mode, and there's hey, Rapspace, how are you? And there's also going to be the fleet battle mode, which is gonna be like the bespoke mode for Star Wars Squadron. So a lot of people are saying, according to the reports that we are hearing, a lot of people are saying that Star Wars Squadron is just, you know, a full game based on the Starfighter mode of Battlefront 2. And apparently, according to what, because a lot of people have been playing, like they're, you know, the EA game changers. I'm not an EA game changer, but a lot of people have been saying that it is absolutely completely different than the Starfighter mode from Star Wars Battlefront 2. The only thing that there are actually two things that are the same from the Starfighter mode in Battlefront 2. The engine is the same, so that's number one. And number two, it's also the AI. The AI, especially the not the big ship AI, but the small ship AI, you know, like the other AI fighters that are around you, are also the same as in Battlefront 2. Everything else is completely different. The controls are going to feel much closer to what we are seeing in Star Citizen, for example. Ships definitely have mass. You're going to have to work on your power units, you know, whether, you know, engine power, shield power, or also weapon power as well. Each ship is going to be completely unique, apparently, according to what they're seeing. Each ship is going to be completely unique from one another, so it's again going to be different from Star Wars Battlefront 2. In Battlefront 2, for example, the TIE fighter and the X-Wing are exactly the same, right? They're just mirroring each other. It's not going to be like that at all in this game, and apparently, what I've been reading from people who are not used to playing Starfighter games, or at least you know, space games, like for example, I read an article from The Verge. Apparently, if you are not used to flying to in these kind of games, then flying is very hard, according to multiple articles that we can see around there. So, I like the fact that if you want to be decent at this game, you're gonna have to learn flying skills, which apparently is what the prologue is going to be for. So there's gonna be apparently like there's a prologue and then a campaign, according to various reports. The prologue, which is kind of like the tutorial, is lasting for about an hour, which is kind of what you would expect for this kind of game, I suppose, right? Also, that we see a lot of that UI here. You see those defend points, the objectives up there, how much time there's left, and also the comms on the top left. All of that can be removed if you want to play in hardcore mode. This is how I will be playing the game, by the way. I will not be playing with all of that UI, which I think is a little bit immersion breaking. But if you want, you will be able to completely disable it and only keep the ship instrument stations of the game, and that's fantastic. Kodak Gaming says that he's getting it. He still hasn't bothered pre-order, but it's on my list. I pre-ordered it, Kodak Gaming. I pre-ordered it. I'm really, really excited about it. The other thing that's different between Battlefront 2 and this game is, you know, I mentioned, for example, how you can fully control your ship. In Battlefront 2, you don't control your ship. For example, if you want to stop your engines, you can't. You're always moving forward. You are moving forward slowly, but you're always moving forward. In Star Wars Squadron, you want to be stopping your ship, putting it at zero. You can't do that. You know, you want to be hiding behind an asteroid and wait until some ships are passing by. You can't do that as well. So definitely much more freedom, as in Battlefront 2. So really like what I'm seeing. Now, also, of course, they're also trying to stay true to the lore as much as possible. So a lot of the panels that you see, a lot of the indications that you see in the cockpit are close as possible to what you can also see in the movies, which I also find very impressive, that fidelity. Look at that. This is also something I want to talk about here. So there's also a kill camp. I'll talk about it later. So that whole fidelity here, trying to be as close to the movies as possible, is something that I also find very exciting. So I don't know if you guys noticed, but there's actually a kill cam in the game. So whenever you died, you have like the porno view of the ship that actually killed you, and you can get to understand what happened and why you died. I thought that this is also a very nice touch. Still undecided. This is really a step forward from TIE Fighter, the original. Well, Black Ship Boys, yes and no. Yes and no. I think that this game is a step forward compared to X-Wing versus TIE Fighter, but not TIE Fighter, because TIE Fighter was basically a campaign, right? The campaign is not going to be the focus of this game. The focus on this game is going to be more multiplayer. So that's why I would compare this game more to X-Wing versus TIE Fighter compared to the actual TIE Fighter or X-Wing Alliance as well. But nevertheless, I still think that it is very much a step in the right direction. The Star Wars franchise, when it comes to video games, has been mismanaged by EA for far too long. And it's great to see that finally we are getting to see passion progress, passion projects, we are getting to see single player games like Jedi Fallen Order, we are getting to see more niche games like this, a space combat shooter. I mean, we were told for so many years, even by the old Lucasfilm back when it was owned by George Lucas, that we would never get a space sim anymore. And there we go, it's coming in right here in 2020. Yes, Black Ship Boys, it is awesome, I agree with you. Rapspace says that he used to play X-Wing versus TIE Fighter. Oh, me too, man. I played all of the old X-Wing games. Absolutely. So at the beginning, yeah, it's not gonna be a lot of maps, you know. They're only gonna have 6 maps and 8 fighters. They said that there wouldn't be no microtransactions and no DLCs, but they did not rule out the possibility of having future DLCs. For example, you know, you don't have any TIE Defenders. Where are the TIE Defenders? Where are the B-Wings, right? So it's obvious that if the game is a success, there is going to be at least one DLC with the B-Wing and the TIE Defender, because that's how it has always been with Star Wars games. Yeah, I like that. You know, it's all voiced. Even your character is voiced. Like you can customize even how your voice, your character is going to sound like. You have like a dozen different voice options for male and females. So kind of like that as well, right? Carlton XL says maybe someone figure out how much money they could make if they please their customers. Yeah, right. Exactly, Carlton. Well, I think that is the opposite, Carlton. I think that they figure out how much money they would lose if they don't please their customers, right? Shocking how it works. Exactly. But yeah. So let's have a look here. What I really like also is that you have also a lot of hints from the old X-Wing TIE Fighter and X-Wing vs. TIE Fighter game, especially with the you know, the fonts. That's something that I've been talking about for quite some time when I've been covering this game. Look at the radar down here and how those ships move around the radar. This is exactly how it was in the old X-Wing games, and also the fonts. You can see the 150, all those fonts are also exactly how they were in the original X-Wing game back from 1993, which I think is also a very interesting Easter egg compared to, it's a very interesting Easter egg for this game. So that's what I wanted to talk about here regarding Star Wars Squadrons. Really excited, very, very positive. I'm very positive about this game. Got a really good feeling about this. Hope that this guy's gonna die. Yeah, there we go, right? And that's all for this video. Big shout out to Eckhart Slathered or X2 for giving the community. Hey, there's an ad. For giving the community this. This video that doesn't have any voiceover, so we can really have a great idea about what this game is going to be. That's all for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching this. I'll see you guys later for more content. This is the Eradicator. I'll see you guys later. Alright, guys, that's all we'll be doing here. That's all we'll be doing in this live stream. You guys have been awesome. Thank you so much.